बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम, इन द नेम ऑफ अल्लाह द मोस्ट बेनिफिसेंट एंड द मोस्ट मर्सीफुल। अस्सलाम वालेकुम स्टूडेंट्स, वंस अगेन वेलकम पाकिस्तान इंटरनेशनल स्कूल बाय वर्चुअल लर्निंग सिस्टम। दिस लेक्चर इज फॉर ग्रेड सेकेंड ईयर बॉयज एंड गर्ल्स पाकिस्तान स्टडीज। Today we will discuss chapter 3 exercise and then we will start chapter 4. Chapter 3 Geography of the Islamic Republic of Pakistan, Physical Feature. We will discuss the exercise of chapter 3 and this is reduced syllabus of chapter 3 Geography of Islamic Republic of Pakistan. Geography of Pakistan, imbalanced economic growth and regional disparities, geostrategic position, attraction for tourists, gateway to landlocked countries, Afghanistan, Central Asian states. This is your reviewed syllabus and now we discuss first of all fill in the blanks. A dash kilometer long boundary separated Pakistan from the People's Republic of China 600. A narrow strip of Afghan territory named back separate Tajikistan from Pakistan. This is Wakhan. Next, Gilgit and Baltistan lie on the boundary of neighboring country, China. In the Cold War, Pakistan sided with the superpower, America. Historic town of Dehra is situated in the district of Sargodha. Remain of Taxila date back to the great Buddhist ruler Ashoka. Islamabad lies in the foot of the Margala Hill. I repeat, a dash kilometer, a 600 kilometer long boundary. Number one. Number two, a narrow strip of Afghan territory named Wakhan. Number three, Gilgit and Baltistan lie on the boundary of the neighboring country that is China. In the Cold War, Pakistan sided with the superpower America. Historic town of Dehra is situated in the district of Sargodha. Remains of Taxila date back to the great Buddhist ruler Ashoka. Number seven, Islamabad lies in the foot of the Margala Hill. Now, MCQ question number two. Pak-India boundary is dash kilometer long, 2100 kilometer long. In old book it is given 1600, but in the new book now it is 2100 kilometer long. About 10% of Pakistan's territory falls in the category of plains, 40%. Average rainfall in the coastal area of Pakistan is 175 millimeters. The province of Balochistan covers about 10% of the total area of Pakistan. 44%. That is 44%. Balochistan is the biggest province of Pakistan and it covers a large area of Pakistan and it is 44%. Bala Hisar Fort is situated in the dash KPK. It is situated in the KPK province. That is also called the city of saints, Madinatul Awliya. Multan is also called the city of saints, Madinatul Awliya. That enjoys a superb position in the health resort of the province of Balochistan, Ziyarat. The superpower Soviet Union dismembered in the year 1989. Three out of that section of the motorway project have so far been completed. A. Pakistan has a common border with China's Muslim majority province Xinjiang. True false. Question number three. True false is given in your book. You will do yourself. True false. And question number four. Put right parts together. Match the column. Also, you will do this. In during lecture, we have discussed. Each and everything is two. Question number three and question number four, you will do. Now, question number five, short question. Answer each question in 2 to 4 lines, but you will write complete answer, not only 2 line answer. Give Pakistan exact area in square kilometer and its location on the globe with reference to the longitude and latitude. Latitude answer is given. A very first page here, chapter 3 is started. First paragraph location, complete paragraph of location you will write in this answer. Question number 2. Describe Pakistan's position with reference to her neighboring countries with the length of a common boundary sphere with neighbors. Same page. Next paragraph, boundaries. Complete paragraph of boundaries you will write in this answer. Write the names of the mountains as well as mountain range lying to the north, west and west of Pakistan. The next page answer is given. Page number 48, mountain range, you know, southern, western mountain range and northern mountain range, then the further division. And in this question, it is asked northwest and west of Pakistan. West of Pakistan, these are Khetar range, Suleiman range, Waziristan range, Sawat and Chitral range, the Fatehpur range. Northwestern mountain range, these are Hindu Kush range. You will write this answer. Next, write a note on the seasons of Pakistan. Very simple and easy question. Answer is given page number 48, seasons of Pakistan. You will just write the name of the seasons of Pakistan and you will mention when the season starts and ends in which month. Next question, indicate the differences of population between different regions of Pakistan. Differences of population between different regions of Pakistan. Answer is given page number 50, page number 50, first paragraph. First paragraph, enormous disparities are found among the different regions and provinces of Pakistan. Some of these are due to natural factors, while others can be ascribed to bad planning and faulty management of affairs. Punjab has 7.36 crore population, Sindh 3.41 crore, the NWSP 1.77 crore, and Balochistan only 65 lakh population. On the other hand, Balochistan covers about 44% of the total area of Pakistan, Punjab only 26%. This shows that the population of Pakistan is very unevenly divided out of the total 23 cities having a population of more than 2 lakh, only one, that is Quetta, is located in Balochistan. Only one out of the 5 most populous cities of the country, that is Karachi, is located in the province of Sindh. The remaining 4 are in the Punjab. These are Lahore, Faisalabad, Rawalpindi, and Multan, respectively. Next question, write a note on the imbalance of economic growth between different regions of Pakistan. Imbalanced economic growth, page number 51. And the answer is in the second paragraph. There is also great disequilibrium with respect to industrial development. Most of the industry in the province of Sindh is concentrated in Karachi and Hyderabad. In the province of Punjab, cities like Faisalabad, Gujranwala, Sialkot, Sheikhupura and Lahore have the biggest concentration of industrial units. Remainder of the Punjab has little or no industrial development. Balochistan and the NWSP are industrially underdeveloped, although the government has declared hubs in Balochistan and Gadun in the NWSP as tax-free zone and have given incentives for setting up industries. Yet these provinces have to cover a long way before they come at par with the Punjab and Sindh. Next question, bring about central position Pakistan enjoys as a significant state of the Muslim world. Answer is given page number 53. The first point, Pakistan's geostrategic position. The first point, central position in the Muslim world. By virtue of its location, Pakistan occupies a central position in the Muslim countries of the world. Pakistan is located in the middle of the extensive chain of the Muslim nation, spreading from Morocco in the west to Indonesia in the Far East. Appreciating this extreme position, the Vice President of Libya, Abdus Salam Jalloud, during his visit to Pakistan in 1978, called Pakistan the heart of the Muslim world. Next question, enlist three main objectives of tourism. Three main objectives of tourism. During lecture, I also told you, page number 55, first line, tourism serves three main purpose or objectives. Number one, research and text finding. Number two, attainment of knowledge and information. Number three, recreation. Next question, under what major heads important sites of tourist attraction can be studied? Same page, number 55, Pakistan offers an enormous barrier of tourist attraction to satisfy all these needs. Tourist attractions in Pakistan can be divided into three main categories. Number one, archaeological barrier. Number two, historical buildings. Number three, health and recreation resort. Question, next question. In this important hill resort of the Punjab and the KPK. Same page number 55, second last paragraph, and also the last paragraph. Murree and Patriata are the most attractive hill station in the province of Punjab. Moving higher within a radius of 60 to 70 kilometers, Ayodhya, Kanpur and Nathia Valley are the panoramic hill stations located in the NWSP. Beautiful valley of Kaman and Sawat also lies in the NWSP, located near Naran in the Lake Tepulmalup, one of the most ravishing high altitude lakes in the world. Chogan and Silipaya are the other tourist attractions located in the same vicinity. In the valley of Sawat, Tebu Sharif, Malkalazar, Bahrain and Kalam are the well-known tourist attractions. Malam Jabba and Niyadam are emerging as comparatively new hill retreats in the same area. Bring next question, bring out Peshawar tourist importance. Page number 56, second paragraph. Page number 56, second paragraph. Peshawar, the headquarters of the KPK, is an ancient city famous for Balahisar Fort, engraved copper utensils, base coat, sandals decorated with embroidery and glasswork, and its bazaar filled with the mouth-watering redolent of chapli kebab. The most remarkable of these bazaars, the Chistakhani, is now a living legend. Now the short question is completed. Long question, you will learn according to your reduced syllabus. Long question, write an essay on world imbalance, economic growth and regional imbalance. What is the importance of Pakistan location from geographical and strategic point of view? What is the importance of the Central Asian state with reference to their relationship with Pakistan? According to your reduced syllabus, you will learn all the long questions in detail. Now, chapter 4, step towards an Islamic Republic of Pakistan. Today also we will start chapter 4. And the reduced syllabus of chapter 4, the topics which are included, number 1, significance and impact of Objective Resolution 1949. Number 2, Islamic provision in the constitutional only 1973 constitution. Number 3, step towards Islamization since 1949. That's the number 8 topic is included in your syllabus. Salient feature words, Human Rights Declaration 1948, and the last topic which is included according to your reduced syllabus, that is Khutba Hujjatul Wida, the Comprehensive Charter of Human Rights. These topics are included in your syllabus chapter 4. Today the topic which we will discuss, the first topic, significance and impact of the Objective Resolution 1949. Objective Resolution, this resolution passed on March 12, 1949, and the resolution resolution was moved in the assembly by the first prime minister Nawab Sada Liaquat Ali Khan, and this resolution, this objective resolution, these were the guiding principles, the point of this resolution, they were the guiding principles for the constituent assembly of Pakistan. And also these points and solve the problems, and it decides the objective resolution decided it clearly the character of the Pakistan, and it clearly mentioned that it will be the Islamic state. The first and the foremost problem for the constituent assembly, the assembly which has to design or the make the constitution of the Pakistan. After the creation of Pakistan, the main demand, you know, that no country can run without a constitution, the basic law of the country. So the constituent assembly was established, and the main purpose to make the constitution for the country, and the first and the main problem for the constituent assembly was of deciding the character of the state of Pakistan, and this problem was done nicely and clearly in the objective resolution, and it was clearly mentioned that the Pakistan will be an Islamic republic, and according to this resolution, under the objective resolution, the state of Pakistan, for the first time, a very first time, it was clearly declared or proclaimed, officially proclaimed, Islamic social order to be ultimate objective, and it clearly stated that Islamic principles, Islamic teachings, Quran of Sunnah, Islamic injunctions shall serve as guiding principle for constitution making. The objective resolution manifests clearly national consensus, and it was declared by the ulama from all, it was signed by the ulama from all schools of thought. The resolution was made a permanent part, a part of preamble, starting or introductory part in all the successive constitution of Pakistan. Preambles are not generally discussable part of the constitutional document, being recommendatory in nature. These are not legally binding, but cannot be invoked before the court of law. In order to give the objective resolution a legal status, a permanent status, preamble, it was made a permanent part of the constitution after the 8th amendment change. And this objective resolution, it was made a permanent part of the constitution and the preamble of the constitution after the 8th amendment. It can be asked in long questions, significance and effect of the objective resolution 1949, and also it can be asked in short question, right, any three significance of the objective resolution. Thank you, students. Hope you understand today's lecture. Have a nice day. Allah Hafiz.